All right, now we will see how to read the external analog IOs, okay? Now in this case, the first step is you go to a variable. So you define a variable where you want to read your external IOs. So here I will, first you have to go offline whenever you're trying to make a new logic or make some changes, you have to be offline. So you can go offline from here, connect or disconnect. Disconnect is offline, connect is online in a dissimilar term. So here I will write analog. You can take any name, 01, my first channel of analog. And I will use it as external, all right? Now, once it's external, you know what to do. Go to your project, this controller properties, and here you will find your analog input, which is AIOIN01, and just define the PLC variable here. Okay, one more thing before I define it here. You see that it doesn't show anything here. I forgot to explain, you go back to your main. This analog IO is not Boolean. This is your analog input. So in this case, I will take double integer. This is the data type. I hope you're sure or aware about the data types. In PLC, we have different data types, Boolean, integer, double integer, word, float. Okay, so you define as double integer. Go back to your project. And here I will define. Okay, wait a second, we have some error. What is the error? The data type are not equal. Okay, let's go back here because I defined the data type before and maybe it has some problem. Wait, let me check. This was analog zero, I will delete it. This was defined before when I made a mistake. Now come back here and analog input. 01 and select analog 01, which I define in the PLC. Now this is linked double integer to my external analog input. Okay, that's how you can link it. So if you see in our project, in our PLC trainer, we have this potentiometer. This one is directly linked to analog input 01. This is already wired inside my PLC trainer. So once you have a trainer similar like this one, this is already wired to analog input 0. So we have defined the variable. Now let's go and download this project. And then we can monitor when I change the knob on the potentiometer, I will see a variable input in 0 to 10 volts. Okay, so by default, my analog input 1 is set to 0 to 10 volt. I can show you where you can change that in case if you have a current input. So if you open this analog IO here in XU line, and if you open all the properties, maybe go to parameters. So this is right now faded because we are online. So you can see here, input channel 1, 0 to 10 volt. That's the frequency of reading, and that's the resolution. So you can change this to plus minus 0 to 10 volt, depends upon what's your analog input. If it's giving you value in minus, in case of some sensors, you can also use that. 0 to 5 volt, if you like, you can also have this range, plus minus 5 volt and the current range as well. Or you can make it inactive. So we have linked the analog input 0. I will connect again. And now I will go back to my main task. It should open. Wait, let me just write and start again. Now it's opened. So if you go to the variable, you can see there is a value, 11286. And now this value is coming from my potentiometer. So this is automatically scaled. So for example, if I make it 0 volt, I see 0 here. If I make it 10 volt, you see somewhere 301145. And of course, there is some noise in the signal. That's why you can see something like this. So you have this analog range from 0 to 30115 or 120 practical range, which you are reading in the PLC. Of course, it's a 16-bit resolution. So whatever value you get by 2 raised to the power 16 is the digital range. So if you want to see, I can show you. So you have 2 to the power 16. So this is the range for positive and negative. So 65536. So the range is 32767768. Okay. So you are getting 30. So it doesn't matter. So now I want to show you this value in our logic analyzer. I hope I can add from here. Add to logic analyzer. And I will open it here. And I just want to see my analog input and start. So that's my value coming here, and I can change the value, and you can see the value is getting automatically scaled and reduced here. So you can see the values are getting changed, and you can track the values in this logic analyzer. This is one way to do that. So you can also make a program to scale these digital values into voltage values. So you can show from 0 to 32,000 to 0 to 10 volt. This you can do by scaling. In the future videos, we will be doing some exercises, and I will show you how to do that. But in this video, it's just about reading the analog input in our PLC. So that's the value coming for channel 1 for the analog input. Now, let's say we want to move this value to analog output. So in this case, I will just move the analog input to analog output. Okay, now the good thing is our both analog input and analog output are 16 bit. So if you see analog channel output channel 1, and where I can see that, maybe it's given in the parameters. Okay, it's not mentioned here, like the resolution, but it's given in the manual that both input and output are 16 bit. So what I can do is I'll go back to my project, to my PLC program, and go to my code, go to offline, go to variables, and I'll write output 01. Now in this case, the supported data type is Word. So you have to use Word here, which is also 16 bit. And make it external. All right, now you know what to do. Go back to your controller properties and the data list, and here find out the output 01 and select PLC output 01. So my output variable is linked to PLC output analog output. Now what we have to do is go back to main and go back to code. So I want to move analog input to analog output. Okay, so in this case my analog input is integer, but I need an output in Word. So what I will do is I will search here. It's quite good, you can search the instructions here. I will type Word, and you will see to Word. So this is a data type conversion to Word. So I will take this one here. And in the input, I will take analog input 01. In the output, what was the tag? I forgot. Oh, it was output 01. Maybe I type. Okay, I will use output 01 at the moment. So output 01. Okay. And I will put this little bit here, make a small comment. Analog IOs. It here, and now to monitor the analog output, I need to have a device. So maybe I will use my multimeter. That would be good enough. So I'm going to write and start the project. So it will download the project. Waiting for controller to start. Now project is written. I will open my main instance again, and you can see the values are coming in the output as well. Now to ensure the values are coming correctly and it's properly linked to my analog input, I have to show you by multimeter. So I will pause this video, I'll connect my multimeter to my trainer, and I will show you that in the camera. So you can see now my analog output is connected to a multimeter. So when I change my analog input, when I rotate the knob, I will see my output is also changing. So my knob is at 6 volt, and you can see analog output 6 volt as well. Maybe I can make it a little bit bigger to show you how does it look. So you can see that it's currently at 6 on the camera. And I move when I move completely at 10 volt, I can see 10.05. So that's how you can monitor your analog output in the multimeter, just by connecting the two terminals to the multimeter needs. Or if you have an analog actuator, you can also connect it to a PLC and it can start getting the voltage. So this PLCnext trainer has two analog inputs and two analog outputs, and analog outputs are currently set at 0 to 10 volts. And if you go here, and just like I explained you before, output channel 1 is 0 to 10 volt. It can be plus minus 10 volt, 0 to 5 volt, or in the current. So you have both possibilities, either analog output voltage or analog output current. So this was about how to work with analog IOs in PLCnext, and I hope it's quite easy. You just have to define the variables, select the right data type, and just download the program, and then you have everything there. And you have a lot of instructions here, a lot of instructions to play around with your values, which we will see in some of the future videos, where I will be connecting my factory IO, which has a pre-built industrial scene, so we can have a good programming lessons. And I will try to use my analog IOs or digital IOs to work with this factory IO. All right, so thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next video with a new topic.